All right. Tuesday morning. First day of rain. As you can see, you can't see shit up there. Just clouds eating the whole top half of the mountain. It's very wet. It's been raining all night. But we've had about an hour of no rain. Thanks, mate. Alright, so we're gonna drop in for first warm-up lap of the day. And this is, I think, this is my first time riding Whistler in like a solid day of rain. So I don't really know what to expect. I've been here for like a minute or two of showers, but not like it pissed all night. At one point we thought a fan got left on, but it wasn't a fan, it was just the sound of beating fucking rain. This might be a little slick. Going high. Yeah. Oh, here's some slick bits. If there's any sunlight, it's gonna dry out. But most of Whistler is in the shade. So it's gonna be really wet in the trees. And then pretty dried up when you're not in the trees. Nice. Nice flow. Despite being so wet. Still feels pretty good. So this section should be pretty dry. This is a nice exposed section here. Little puddle there. All right, this is a bit slick here, I know. That corner is really stamped down. Nice. So far, so good. Nice. One thing about the wet is it's a double-sided sword, because shit like this becomes way more grippy. The loose, dry stuff gets a little, you know, muddy and it gets grippy. The other side of that sword is that anything that's rocky gets really slippery. So rain is a bit of a blessing and a curse, if you catch my drift. One of the things that's really deceiving about the rental bikes is they give you like a jersey and pants and shit, so you're like, is this person good or is this person just here for the weekend? All right, you can always tell by the shoes. I always jokingly say that with Lisa. I say, look at this guy in his fucking Air Jordans. I mean, here's the thing though, some people are wearing like Adidas shoes and they're still ripping. So that's not always the rule, but it is pretty funny when you see buddy on a rental bike and he's got like a $400 Troy Lee design helmet on and like $250 worth of pants and jersey. And then he's got his like wingtips. We're gonna pre-slow here. There's no one behind us, so I don't really want to slam through this bit in the wet, because it's just so fucking gross. It's temporary, but still, Like, would it have killed him to just carve that out a bit better? Maybe that wood bridge that they're bypassing there, like, fell apart. And it was do what you can when you can. So they just made do. They're flowing okay. I'm gonna fall in behind them. No one coming behind us, so if I catch them, it won't be a big issue. All right. Let's keep her going, keep her going, keep it going full steam. Oh, that's a little sketchy. Doing the full speed, no berm turn. Oh, I just about lost my inside there. Whew. All right. Good warm up. Despite being like 15 Celsius, I'm feeling pretty warm. Probably because I'm wearing like 12 pounds of gear. Phew. All right. Oh, good warm up. Let's take a little breather. Take five, get some water. All right, guys. It's supposed to just pour today, but the weather's actually been pretty nice. It's like it's cool, but as soon as you stop moving, the body heat really picks up. All right, dropping in, crank it up. Lap two, first day of rain. making for a really odd mixture of grippy and loose. Let's go high on this thing. Nice. Fuck. Jesus. That was a completely unintended flip from the right side of the jump to the left side of the jump. And I came down just a little cockeyed. Maybe we'll edit that bit out. I'm trying to make this just a highlight reel. Step up into the big booter. Nice. Oh, if you heard that little zit, that was my ass hitting the tire. Came up a little short, so I tried to pull it in. And I heard the little bleh. Came up short there. Yowza. Feeling good? I think this is the sweet spot for grip for me, where it's just a little bit of moist dirt, but nothing crazy, right? Like, I hate the dry, and I don't mind like mud, like really wet, because I'm pretty good at just taking my time in those situations. But I think honestly, this is the sweet spot. All right. I think I'm gonna grab a little bite to eat here. It's coming up on, it's probably like 1 now. I don't know. Oh fuck, it's not even 12 yet. I'll grab something light. All right. Lap 3, first rainy day. Thank you. Didn't quite clear that for some reason. No idea why. Thought for a split second there, I was like, is that a bear? I looked to my left, it's just a big guy on a bike. He was wearing all black, in my fairness. He was wearing all black. Yeah, it was just like a husky dude in all black. And I was like, is that a bear? No, it's not this guy down here. He did the drops and went down that way. Just, yeah. Now I feel bad. all right. Let's do... We could bypass lower, crank it up, and do like beeline into some techie stuff. But then I get spit out down into the bottom of A-line. I don't really want to do that in the wet, so fuck it. Like you would think after riding crank it up like 100 times in 2 years, I would get bored. But here we are. And I still love riding this trail. Nice little style. Get some skis. Getting skeezy. Used to be a nice little step up right there. Again, I don't know what they're doing over there, but it sure is disruptive to my cruising. Nice, nice, even flow. Good flow. Nice. Soared that one a little too high. All right, some of my favorite jumps here. Yeet. This one's a pretty big one. But now, probably my most well tricked out jump is this step up right here. Yeet. I've gotten pretty good at throwing whips on that one because it's low consequence. What I mean by low consequence is that with the step up, you're not jumping way up in the air and then falling way down onto a landing pad. You're jumping up and your landing pad is elevated. So of course that means you've got that extra little landing area. You've got that extra close landing area. This is right at the apex of your jump. So if you did like absolutely eat shit, you're only falling like 3 feet to the ground. rather than, you know, one of those big ass dirt jump style things like every other jump on that trail. If you eat shit, you're gonna fall like 10 feet to your death. So yeah, I really like the step ups. That's the only place I really feel comfortable trying things right now. Yeah, I feel like I'm having fun on that last little rhythm section. It's very pumpy. Nice. Getting really comfortable tabling on my left side. Right, like this is easy, but my body's so rigid and stiff. When I try and go the other way, it's the weirdest thing. It is the weirdest thing. Right, I think I should probably just go because I don't know where that guy on the rental trek is. But I wouldn't mind staying in front of them. All right. That's a big jump. Not a fan of this step up. It's just weird. All right. Let's try and get some speed here. Yeah. Try and get a little whip on this. Yeah. Getting just steezy. If I could just do that on every trail, I'd be such a pimp. All right. Fucking just flying lap. Nice. I just felt a raindrop. Definitely wet again. So anything that's pretty darn slippery is gonna have to be taken with ease. That looks slippery as fuck. I probably shouldn't have done that. Yeah. I do love that jump.
Have you done the third one up there?
I do far right. Like the sort of tallest one. I mean, the little ones, like, if you're a beginner, just hit the far left.
Is it any better than the one on A-line? Because I've done that, like, a bunch.
Oh, yeah, no. Like, rock drop at A-line?
No, the one squirrel catcher.
Yeah, you'll be fine. Yeah, if you're riding A-line, you'll be fine here. Yeah, brother, take it. How's that?
Incredible.
Felt good, eh? Right on, brother.
Awesome.
Have a good laugh, eh?
Have a nice day.
You too, brother. that kid's like the epitome of stoke. I'll boogie through.
Okay.
Right on. Thanks, guys. Took us a while to get our turn there. Oh, it's pretty sloppy. I'm not doing the wall ride, no way. So fucking wet. Everything is just soaked. See if I can get ahead of those kids. So dark. Oh. so fucking wet. Slipping all over the place. Should go slower, but don't want to. Whew. All right. I think that's probably my last lap for the day, I think. So I got 2 days left and I don't want to burn out. And my wrists are already just fucking jacked. Just fucked up. So let's do a bike wash and get the fuck out of here.